Hello there. What's your weakness? A question mark. Oh, we have to use stealth? Strife. It doesn't seem to be working. You're even more creeped out than you already were, which was severely. Dance like nobody's watching. Success? Pardon me, boy. Can you give me a shine? Give you a shine? Fill them with daylight. Not do anything? Flash step. Stepper luck next time. I don't know if that's doing anything. Step gingerly. 1,000 yard a stair. Get it. Encore. Yawn, snore. Distracting, delectable. Delectable, disdained. He doesn't want them? Oh god, you're trying to punch the pigeon? Flip the flap out. Flip skipped. Charge. Get it? Meta luck next time. The only thing I haven't tried is this. Too precious to weaponize. Am I supposed to skip my way over there or something? When the pogs slam and scatter, clatter and scatter, do they not possess a grace all their own? Is their dance any less a defiance of that cruel tyrant gravity than is yours? No, they do not, and yes it is. Okay, it's saying that because I combine that with that. So that makes it go over there. I distract it with a light, maybe? Hey, over here! Nothing doing. What makes it come over here? Nothing doing. I'm afraid that you've used up all the time I allotted for helping you. Just keep throwing yourself at the task at hand, and I'm sure you'll solve it eventually. Even if it is through brute force rather than through the application of a finely tuned intellect such as mine. This thing never does really give any hints, does it? It doesn't like them. I forget, what makes it come over here again? Can you give me a shine? Shine here? Can I move? I can't move from this spot. So now that it's here, with the flashlight, if I do something it doesn't like, maybe you want pogs here? Face full of slammers. Get a coffin ready. He says, give me a shine. Okay. So tap. Tap dance. Then shine the flashlight. Pogs seem to work. Mercy not included. Sell you later. At least I'm not talking endlessly. How's that? Can I treat you? Treat yourself. Flash that. Is there some kind of like random number thing? Tough crap, maybe you need something with a little more flash. What else has flash? Maybe I put these batteries in there. Oh wait, I mean that. No. How's the beret? How's the board? Got the pogs again? Oh, you don't want to come over there. That's right, we need to do the dance first. See, and that flashes. but I can't really do anything about it. Opening night. Pan. I'm not sure what to do here, guys. Maybe we just need to hit him some more times with stuff? I don't know. Oh, that didn't work. I need to... Oh, it did work. Never mind. I thought I was hitting the wrong thing. I don't know. That turns him around. The pogs don't seem... I mean, they do hit him. All this, these things hit him, but... They either are... They either don't work, or they have to hit him a certain amount of times. Either one. Maybe I hit him now with it. No, the flash step happens when he's turned around the other way. When he's turned around this way. Step gingerly. Maybe I wait till he's turned around and then throw the stuff at him? I think every time I've thrown stuff at him has been when he's facing me. So if I throw stuff now, he'll be unprepared. Playing for keeps. That makes him go back over there. No take backs. He still turned around though. Meta luck next time. It hits me too. Sell high. Bye, Joe. Hmm. I don't think that works for us. Backs turned. Encore. Yawn snore. Opening night. Hand. I don't know. Have I tried everything? Oh! I got magic spice mix? I saw that glinting over there, but I was like, what can I do? A shaker full of season-all magic spice mix. This doggone powder adds a taste of flavor to every bite. The mysterious chemical process is that produces power from the silver nubs of these batteries. They don't need any assistance from your sweet or your savory. You don't hate pogs because they're bland. That would be a relief. They're so in-your-face and intense and radical, you can't stand them. Turn 12 already, pogs. Now, they're already irresistible to pretty much all animals. Why gild a lily? Your precious heirloom is already quite magical, thank you, and you have no desire to eat it. You don't really have any strong feelings about trying to use your spice mix with your tap dancing or whatever, so you're just going to list some words that might either be spices or tap dancing terms. Ready? Okay. Bobberchay, grapevine, tanglefoot, riffle, cubanola. Now, how many of those were tap and how many were spice? Give it all. Give up all tap. Tap dancing is wild. A light touches everything in the kitchen and on stage. Alright, so let's use this on it. Spice to meet you. Mix the mark. I'm guessing I drag it back over here. Make its eye turn to face me. And then throw the spice at it. Oh wait. Give him a shine. Then throw the spice. Right in your face. Oh. Mixed success. Awesome. Joey, thank you for tactically brilliant seasonings murder. Byers has payload. Repeat, Byers has payload. Over. Thanks, do you know how I might get him down? He seems pretty terrified. Negative, Byers simply has unfortunate mercenary streak. Should respond to enticement, over. How do you bribe a pigeon? Sounds like a setup for a riddle or perhaps joke, over. Bye, Jude. Over and out. Monstre behind thing. Can I look at it? No? It's actually more difficult to see through the window now that it has a hole in it. Well, it's already pretty dang open due to it being broken. It looks like all that fracas with the monster got him pretty shook up. You might have to find something here in the kitchen you can tempt him with. As you do not have flight capability, the pigeon remains out of reach. Maybe he needs enticing? What do pigeons like? Treats? Spices? The pigeon just saw you kill that monster with this stuff. There's no way he'll go for it. Yeah, they are pretty intelligent. The coy wink of the setting sun off the tip of this copper-top dynamo holds no interest for your feathery quarry or his mysterious parcel. He hungers for something else. Maybe something from the cupboard? You're just tossing ideas around here. If pogs are what it takes to get him off the fridge, he can stay up there. There's got to be something else around here he'd be more into. No, he can't have it. He might fly off with it and then immediately be eaten by a monster. And then where would you be, figuratively, and also, where would your precious heirloom be, literally? Nothing. You guess you already saw a fair bit of your fancy footwork when you were dealing with that monster. No response. Either that, or he was completely enraptured by your elegance and grace. You prefer to believe the latter, but that really doesn't solve your problem. Oh, I see, yeah, these are open. You need to tempt this little fellow with something bad. Something like garbage, but food. Okay. I guess he doesn't want this. Oddly enough, you aren't sure these are safe for birds. After the violent strangled death of that monster, you're a little nervous about just feeding things to other things at random. Maybe there's something safe around here, like bread? Bread-like, at least? A little cracker. Ta-da! The cracker is ours! All you can rate from this meager cabinet is the stalest, tiniest, worst cracker. So we got a cracker now. This stale cracker was sitting in the back of the cabinet for so long that taking it feels like robbing a museum. Still, someone might like it. Now, unfortunately, we can use the cracker on everything, can't we? The spice mix would probably make it taste better, but you're still not going to eat it. Heck, the spice mix would make cardboard taste better, but you're not going to eat that either. That silly pigeon could probably prefer this cracker without a copper topping. Hey, more stale garbage. Today's really looking up for you. What's that the kids say? Tubular? This is just tubular. You combine the stale cracker and pet treats into a sadness bruschetta. Wow. Things have gotten pretty bleak around here, huh? Maybe not that bleak, though you separate the sadness bruschetta into its original ingredients. Both have ridges? That's about all you've got right now. The agitated bird and recently asphyxiated monster are kind of hard to get out of your head. You could stomp all over this cracker or, you know, offer it to that hungry-looking cutie on the fridge. Up to you, really. If you're looking for a partner, you could probably do a lot worse than the little doofus on the fridge. He seems particularly interested in that stale cracker you picked up for whatever reason. Stale crackers don't need to be refrigerated. It's too late for them. Freshness retreats indefinitely, infinitely, always already lost. The spice mix is pretty good, but it can't do much for the flavor of baking soda and a simple moldering orange. You fax the stale cracker to a random number, or rather you fax a black and white image of the stale cracker to a random number. The stale cracker stays where it is, that is to say, in your possession. Boy, you're just really, really thrilled about all of this. You're about to fax a picture of spice to some random person, but you worry it might be hard to collect the spices again afterwards, so you reconsider. Whew, you nearly did something kind of ridiculous and time-wasting. Bullet dodged. That'd probably be best, wouldn't it? But if you start throwing things away just because they were garbage, why, you'd have to throw away most of the stuff you're carrying, really. Hey, whoa now. You're not throwing away the spice mix. It can improve any food. All you need is any food. Opening the door to throw a cracker outside would probably result in you're losing that pigeon, which you're pretty sure you need. Just look at this little fellow. He'd go wild for this cracker. You can just tell. You sprinkle some spice mix across the threshold, hoping to mask the human scent in this house from reaching the monsters outside. None of them seem to have any eyes, which your junior veterinarian's training tells you they primarily rely on smell and hearing to track your prey. They have eyes, just one eye. You consider luring a monster into your kitchen using a crummy old cracker, but you can't count on the next one being so utterly vulnerable to magic spice mix. You can't count on much in this world if you're being honest with yourself. That would upset your dog's sensitive sniffer when he tried to use the very door installed for her ease of access. Not that she looks to be in any hurry to use it, being currently preoccupied with caring in her doghouse and such. You don't want to tempt any more flying monsters to come crashing through the window. You just have to kill them with spice mix, too, and honestly, you're still wrestling with the implications of that, like, ethically. Also, it may have been a fluke. You'd rather not test it out if you don't have to. It's a filthy kitchen, and we have no food, but at least there's a gorgeous view. Yeah, thanks, monsters. And now that you've pocketed the spice mix, you must have missed this kitchen has basically nothing to recommend itself. This? Stale cracker and the oily, hardened remains of some takeout food from... You don't exactly remember exactly when? It must be your birthday. It's not, though. It's not your birthday. Nice try. When there was food in these, maybe, although that would have been kind of gross, just dumping dry spice on already prepared Chinese food, you suggest it to Jude next time. Dog food and a stale cracker. It's... Wow. Things got depressing pretty quick around here, huh? You guessed that monster drying was kind of the canary in the mineshaft that was the gritty grimness factor of your adventure was about to kick into high gear. Even if there were dog food in there, there's bound to be a bad move. A dog's sensitive sniffer would get overwhelmed by the potent flavor sensations contained in this tiny shaker. Oh, sadly, when this guy was mummified, he probably had all his digestive organs removed. He couldn't handle some warm soybeans and cold water, let alone this dry, dusty crunch square. Whatever's keeping this fella from rotting, it seems to be doing the trick on its own. But the minute he starts to go bad, you'll be ready to spice him. Spice him till he's fragrant. Whoa, like that thing in your basement is your pet now? No thanks. You have no interest in forming an emotional connection with a weird monster who terrified you in a basement. That didn't do anything. Better not tempt fate. You just barely escaped that serpent. You mean snake? You mean monster? It's just a monster. Snakes don't have legs. It has a ton of legs. Way more than you, even. You're more like a snake than it is. Okay, you've gotten away from your original point a little, which is that you're not going back down there. Okay, what I'm hoping is that we can't leave the room, otherwise I have to try these things on everything. When you try to leave, you hear a soft, sad coo from the pigeon on the top of the fridge. Surely you're not going to abandon him? What if that monster wakes back up? Besides, doesn't he have something you need? Okay, I'm glad. I can't leave the room to try everything with everything. Alright, here you go, buddy. Success! This little fellow. Byers, you think? Yes, you're pretty sure. This is Byers. It is. Poor Frohickey is dead, and Langley's a traitor. Gobbles down the stale cracker as you tuck him into your pocket. He's got a little parcel around his neck, which you're fine with letting him hold on to until you actually figure out what you're supposed to do with it. We've got a bird now. This is Byers, apparently. He has a little satchel around his neck. Jude says there's some marbles in there, so you guess those will come in handy somehow. Until such a situation presents itself, you're content to let Byers handle marbles duty. Okay, got the marbles. Do you want me to send the pigeon back? No. Over. Okay. Sorry, I didn't mean to shout. Just worried. Please protect Byers. His chances of surviving return trip. Very remote. Over. Okay, yeah, good point. Seems pretty dicey out there. Affirmative. Over. I'll just use these marbles, or whatever, then. I'll let you know how it goes. Affirmative. Good luck, sis. Over and out. What? No. Byers is not a snack. Byers, what do you think of these batteries? Why did you pick them up? What purpose will they ultimately serve? Are you just carrying them out around a sense of curiosity, or is it just inertia? Why do they keep pooping in your hand? Oh, sorry, Byers. That got a little pointed. He's probably going to try to eat them, right? That's what he'll do, because he's a simple little bird brain who... Okay, he's wearing the pog like a little hat. Touché, Byers. That's pretty darn cute. Byers picks the treat up with his beak and, after a moment, spits it back into your hand. Evidently, he doesn't care for the taste. Either that or this bird is literally too dumb to know what food is. Byers is a cutie, but you're not quite sure you want to entrust your shiny, treasured memory of your dearly departed mother to an animal with a fascination for shiny objects and a proclivity for flying out of reach. Good point. Aw, that'll startle the bejesus out of him. Byers gives you a little wink as if to say, one day, sure, when you're ready. Wow, talk about fresh. Into the fridge you go? Sounds like a great recipe for dead pigeon. You put one of Byers' feathers gently in the fax slot and punch in a random number. Somebody out there just got a fax full of beautiful bird feather, and no one can ever say Joey Claire didn't leave her mark on the world. It's already humming away, drunk on its fresh infusion of restored power. Great work, Joey. You stick some pogs inside the fax machine, dial a random number, and wait for the machine to finish sending the fax. There, now someone has a black and white printout of your brother's crummy pogs. Thank goodness you can put that on your tombstone. Beep boop, beep boop, beep boop, and there, you faxed a pet treat to a random person. You hope it was someone with a dog. Try as you might, you cannot use your heirloom to access the innards of this fax machine. Just did that. You type out a quick fax and do a weird little dance to the horrible sounds it makes when it sends. Wow, this is probably the weirdest thing you've done in recent memory. Congratulations. Though the fax machine singular has been restored to life by you flipping the circuit breaker, you have a feeling that you are in the twilight years of the fax machine in general. This premonition forbades your entire being, tinging your moments with poignancy and the smell of old toner. Alright, I'm done, yeah. Try bird on things. That's for dogs, not pigeons. Also, if you shoved him through there, he'd probably get eaten by monsters, like, immediately. Whoa, hey! Don't insinuate that all pigeons like trash. That is definitely an overgeneralization, and he's pecking a hole in the trash and trying to eat an old eggshell. Disappointing and weird, Byers. Can't do anything. If we're gonna send him outside, we'll probably just use that huge hole where the window used to be. Too small for a cage, too empty for a meal, too greasy for a bird you plan on putting back into your pocket. Dog food? No, no matter how hungry your pets get, you should never feed them to each other. Wow, geez, Joey. You attempt to send Byers? Yeah, you're pretty sure this is Byers. You attempt to send Byers back to your brother, but he refuses to leave your hand. Maybe he had a rough trip or something. That's fine, you'll hold on to him for a little while longer. You can just tell Byers wants to make an absolute ruin of that hat. Although he would look just as cute as a button while doing so, you can't condone it. Okay, now hope we still can't leave. We can, damn it. Byers. Byers doesn't need to know about your pa's sexy lamp. Let him stay innocent, if only for a little while longer. I don't remember seeing this. The teddy bear outpatient clinic is for stuffed animals who require treatment, but not an overnight stay. It's not just for stuffed bears, of course. It was named for its founder and chief physician, Arsala Teddy Bear. That didn't do anything either. Look at this big old pile of nesting materials. Byers looks as eager as can be to shred these and start pooping and egging all over them. Books, the spice of life. Of pretty dull lives, anyway. Byers is pretty impressed by the wingspan on this thing. This thing had a few too many cooks in the kitchen already.